Hello and welcome by another video of the Arcade Saga. And today I have another care clip for you guys. I must admit, they added me in. It was quite a short notice. So thank you all for putting the effort in. It was close to the finish of this being all set down, this care clip. But there was a little bit room for me as well. So thank you very much for adding me in. And we're going to talk about this arcade here, this one. But I just wanted to give you an overview of my Cattleya types here and some Cattleya, but most of them are Cattleyas. I recently started to collect them more and more, so therefore I do not have very big ones, for an exception of this one. And also my Francis Fox is quite a young plant. But before I'm going to start to discuss how I give what kind of care I give it, I want to would like to mention the other care collabs for this care collaboration. First of all, we have Karen's Argots. Then we have Ray's Garden, Roger's Argots, and Ninja Argots, Nina from Spain, who invented these care collabs. And obviously me as well. So I'm very happy to join in on this one. Like I said, I'm going to move to the arcade that will have the stage for the day. This is the Francis Fox, like I said, and I'm going to take this plant inside and put it on my potting table, and we will have a look inside the pot, and I will talk about the story behind this arcade and how I care for it. And here we are in my arcade room. I have it put the arcade, the Francis Fox, on the table so we can have a closer look. And I see beautiful new roots coming on this latest new growth. Before that, it had these two ones. And as you can see, in comparison to my hand, it's not a very big plant. So what happened was, I think I did bought it from Look Arcades Germany. I'm not 100% sure at this moment, but I have it in my notes. But it doesn't matter that much. But I bought this Francis Fox. I really enjoyed the blooms and seeing on other channels. So therefore I thought, yeah, I'd like to have this one in my collection as well. Turned out I had two young plants in one pot. Sold as one near blooming size arcade. That wasn't the case, if you ask me. It's a very young plant. And the other one did die off quite quickly after I received it. This is about 3 years ago, 2-3 years ago. And so it didn't grow much because I was very struggling. I was working on my self-watering setup. And I'm going to zoom out a bit. Yes. So this plant did go through quite a lot. Therefore, I nearly killed this one as well. But she is coming back now. What happened was the same problem I had with my other orchids. I grow them in self-watering, and I couldn't keep up with flushing. So therefore I did get some problems inside of the pot with the pH, the level of the pH. When you start using inorganic media, most of the times the pH rises quite high, quite quickly. But I did discover that if you don't flush, after about 6 months, something like that, the pH goes down rapidly, and it can go down even below 4.0. I had an arcade that was around 3.6, lost all the roots, obviously. It was way too low, but now I'm working with that. So it was kind of an accident, but now I'm working with a reservoir, with a pot that I barely flush. That's just a way that I like to explore, to try out. I do this now for almost 2 years and I have really good results. So that's why I'm very confident now to share this. It's not that I have complete control, that I completely know what I'm doing, but it's a way to grow. It's something new, I think, on YouTube. But yeah, that's how I am. I like to explore new things. Okay, so this one was a early bought in on my newest collection. I have orchids for around 20 years, but I started recollecting when I had more time for my orchids about 3 years ago. So I started to building up a collection again. This one was one of the first. I did get it out of the pot because he was losing her roots as well, as I explained earlier in this video why. Back then I had no idea. I thought, well, it doesn't like the self-watering semi-hydro, so I started to mount it. And I'm sorry, yeah, I'm starting to laugh because this arc went through so much, because I wasn't experienced enough. I didn't basically know what I'm doing. I was just trying out and learning, but still. So I had it mounted, but I couldn't keep up with the watering mounted this orchid. So I put it back in self-watering, I think, four months ago, I think around that time. But we are working on new roots, finally. So we have quite a nice big root going here, down into the medium. We have one here. Here, there, and there. We have some newer still coming in. I hope you can see that. I will zoom in a bit. And a beautiful root here, straight, going straight for that reservoir. The one that I do not flush. So yeah, we'll talk about that a little bit more, why I don't do that and what happens. But I'm going to zoom in a little bit on the root so I have really a nice idea that I am not lying, that it's really getting beautiful roots again. I hope my camera will focus. You see some beautiful new roots starting there on that base, another one there in the back. And like I said, with my thumb, you have quite a lot of new roots there. We also had one big one in the back. That's this one. And you see it's all the way down into the pot. I'm going to have a look. No, it's still in the pot. I'm sorry. I do not hope I make you dizzy, but it's still in the pot. And now you can see that I have, this is pumice, the gray stuff. This is the good old leca, of leca, just depending how you pronounce it. We call it leca, but and pumice. And I have a top layer of petals. That is something that I copied from the orchid room, Annabelle. And it really works for my plants as well. So that's what I do. I have to admit, I have made a mixture because I have quite a lot of leca. I prefer pumice. Pumice is inorganic, but it's made in nature from, it's basically lava rock, but it's only, was made basically in the air. So the lava was bursting, some lava drips was flying around in the air, dried up, and there you have pumice. So I'm always saying that, I'm sorry for moving as fast as I did. I'm always saying this is inorganic, but it is as organic as you can get inorganic, if you mean what I mean. But yeah, I like to have it as close to nature as I can, but not, I'm gonna zoom out now, but not completely inorganic like bark or moss, because then I have quite a hard time growing in this setup with always water in the pot, as you can see here, and therefore I need inorganic. Okay, so I do not flush this orchid. I do not do that with all my orchids, with one exception, and just grabbing a little tissue here because I'm making a mess. And with one exception is that if I see quite a lot of salt built up, I will flush it. I will soak it, I will flush it until the salts go down quite a bit. But sometimes you do not see the salts on top of the media. So therefore, because I'm measuring quite a lot, I have really some big sheets with all the names on of my orchids, and you will see that on my channel, and I will discuss it from time to time. I keep records of all my orchids, what happens in these pots, because they don't flush, and it's fairly new. I don't know somebody who does it exactly the same as I do, so therefore I think it's fairly new. But like I said early on, I like to try things, try new methods. That's just who I am. But to keep an eye on the salt buildup, I measure every 3 months what happens in the reservoir. And I will do that now with you guys so I can demonstrate what I'm doing. And I'm going to talk about what happens if something goes wrong, how I fix it. First of all, this is a ppm meter, something I cannot live without. I use this for the water, to measure the water that I'm, when I'm watering my orchids, when I foliar feed them, and also measure the reservoirs of my orchids. So let's see how many ppms are in here at this moment. And I will put it on hold. If it stabilizes. Yes, and there we go. Let me see. You can see 121. That's not much. It's not very less, but this is basically around the amount that I water my orchids every time with. You may think, well, that kind of makes sense if you get the same reading. Well, trust me, if the orchid isn't growing or taking up its feed and you're putting feed in and in and in, you will have build up. So this number goes up. I also know that most of the times this number is probably around the half of the amount of salts that are in the pots. I did some tests there. If you are interested in those tests, let me know. I can demonstrate them once, but this video will be too long to talk about it too much. But okay. If it was 200 or more, then it's not okay for me anymore. I know that's kind of the limit for my orchids, that they will start get troubles root-wise. So if they 200 ppms or even more, I will flush them and soak them until I have a reservoir again with a lower pH. Ppm. Around 100 is beautiful. So this one is a little above 100, but it's perfect. It's not a big plant, so okay. I kinda get why it's a little bit higher than 100. But that's the feed. I don't know what is in there at the moment, of course, but I know it's not too much for the root to get damaged. But also the pH is very important. I have this pH meter and I'm going to set it in, because you probably already know that orchids need a certain pH to get their nutrients, to uptake their nutrients. So therefore I keep an eye on this one. I basically try to copy the setup, like I explained earlier. When you just start using inorganic media with your plants, your pH is quite high, but they can take it because they grow the roots, so therefore I knew that they can take it. So I try to keep the pH of the pot a little around 7. So a little bit down 7, a little above. 7.5 is the absolute limit. If it's higher, I have a problem and I will try to lower it. But let me put this on hold as well. Is it on hold? Yeah. Let's have a look. This one is, 6.65. So this would be 6.7 for my nodes, or because we have two extra numbers there. But 6.65 is a beautiful pH. This is after flushing her. I didn't flush her for... No, she's potted for 4 months now in this setup. I didn't flush her in all those months. So this is beautiful. This is really beautiful. I need to clean these up before I use them for other orchids again. But this is what I do. And what you get is a little bit of dirty stuff in there from LECA. But it's not only that, because I also like to use, of course, seaweed. It tends to get a little bit brown as well, and also hummus and other bacterial stuff. I will make a video about the feed that I use. It will be in there, but those it fertilizes. It's not basically fertilizes, more like the hormones, natural hormones I like to use for my plants as well as a fertilizer. But they give a color to the water, so that's why it's a little bit brown. And like I said, I do this for almost 2 years now. Like I just explained in this video, I do not have any problems anymore. So it works for me. And it seems to working for this orchid as well. She's starting to come back, but this is kind of small. I think we will get there. So this is basically what I do for my Francis Fox. And I will now go back into the greenhouse. We will have a look at the temperature, and I'm going to talk about the where she is placed in the greenhouse and what I give her light-wise and temperature-wise. Before I forget, I noticed that some people are a little bit afraid. They say, yeah, you have a staggered water there, water that's standing still for a long time. I kind of disagree. I know, I get why people think that, but remember that at least once a week, but probably twice a week, I give this clean water. I have to water my plants. They drink up the water. So how long does that water be there in that reservoir? That's something to think about, I think. In my experience, like I said, I'm doing this almost for 2 years now. I have not a problem. That's why I'm starting to film this and making this channel into Growing Orchids, because I'd like to share it. It's just a way that it works for me. I'm not saying you should do that, but it works for me. And but I wanted to mention that. And also the air, you want air movement. Every time I fill up the reservoir, the water goes down, the water level goes up. It pushes that air up. So therefore, I think I have enough air circulation in that pot as well. Once again, I do this for quite some years, and I just do not see problems with the roots. So therefore, it's working for me at least. Okay, that said and done, it was for me kind of important to put it in there as well. I'm going to back up a little bit. Remember, there she stands, this is her place. Now we go up a little bit, we have some Cattleya types and some Catasetums there. All orchids that love the sun, because around 10 o'clock the sun is hitting my greenhouse there, and it goes all around till probably 7-8 in the evening. That's a lot, I know. And I was kind of nervous when I had this greenhouse, because I did it was finished last November, so I didn't have a summer yet with this. I am in the Netherlands, so it's not a warm climate, but when the sun is there, and we have that for a few weeks, it can be, in those weeks, get quite warm, and especially in greenhouses, when the sun is hitting the roof and the walls, it will warm up your greenhouse quite quickly. I experienced that. But we have two apple trees there, and a oak tree. No, it's a willow tree. Yeah, it's a willow one. I'm sorry. It's a willow tree there that are giving the shade, especially in the morning, till around 1 or 2 in the afternoon. Then it's open, and therefore I have my vendors here because they like the light. But also my Cattleya types will get quite some light as well, as is that Francis Fox. I think that there are some orchids who really like a little bit more light than the Francis Fox itself, because I see some purpling around the leaves. Let me go back into the orchid, closer up to the orchid. Some darker edges. I hope my camera does pick it up. I think you can see it a little bit there. So that's for me a sign that this is enough light. She doesn't need more. And we have some purple here as well. That's beautiful. It's okay. Not too much. But I don't need more purple. So that's light issue a light situation for this orchid. And then we have the temperature. It's now 26, as you can see, with a humidity of 73. In summer, most of the times it's around 30 when it's summer, and I keep the door open, the fans running. I can keep it around 30. And the humidity drops quite quickly, but I spray my orchid then in the morning when it's around 40% of humidity. I try to get it up, and my sweet spot is around 60-65. If I have it higher for too long, sometimes I will get some moldy stuff going on, or some rotting. I must admit, in this greenhouse, I have my fans normally running 24 hours. It's okay, but still, I need to keep an eye on it. So I think I kept it covered quite a lot. One of these coming years, I hope to that I can show you the blooms on this one. I absolutely love them. It's absolutely one of my most favorite orchids there is. The Francis Fox. If you have any questions, as usual, you may leave them in the comment section. And I hope I didn't miss out on anything. If you want to know more about the feed that I put in, I promise you guys, as soon as I can, I will have a video on which products that I use, if you are interested. I also always use RO water. I keep forgetting to add that in. I have a RO system. I always use RO water mixed in, most of the times, with something feed-wise or hormone-wise. So this is basically it. Thank you all. for being here. I hope you enjoy these videos. I really enjoy them myself. I'm going to absolutely have a look at all the other care collabs who are out there now. I will have their links of their channels in my comment section. In the video description. I'm sorry. And I'm absolutely going to check them out. I think it's a fantastic idea to put all that information out there. That is how I start learning to grow my orchids better. Came up with a sort of system for myself, but I had a good start from other growers. I think that's very important. Once again, thank you for watching, and I really hope to see you at one of my next videos. Bye bye.